Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of God and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
For the peace in the whole world, the stability of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, for those who went with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our Archbishop and Father Savas, the Honorable Presbyters, the Deacons in Christ, for all the clergy and laity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, the President, and all those in public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this parish and city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick and the suffering, the captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For deliverance from affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the
Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Lord our God, whose power is beyond compare and glory is beyond understanding, whose mercy is boundless and love for us is ineffable, look upon us and upon this house and your holy house and your compassion, and grant to us and those who pray with us your abundant mercy. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Ευλογεί ψυχή μου τον Κύριον και πάντα τα εντός μου το όνομα το Άγιον αυτούν. Ευλογή η ψυχή μου των Κυρίων και μη επιλανθάνου πόσος τα σανταποδώσεις αυτούν. Κύριος εν το ουρανό ετοίμασε τον θρόνον αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering the most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, and our whole life unto Christ our God. For yours is the dominion, the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forevermore.
Amen.
Εν η ψυχή μου τον Κύριον, εν έσω Κύριον εν τη ζωή μου, ψαλώ το Θεό μου, έως υπάρχον.
Save us, O Son of God, who rose from the dead.
Άριος ο Θεός Ιακώβ, βοηθός αυτού, η ελπής αυτού, επί Κύριον των Θεών αυτών.
Σώσον ημάς, Ιε Θεό, ο Αναστάσσεχτετος, σάλλοντας η Αλληλούια.
Βασιλεύσει, Κύριος εις τον αιώνα, ο Θεός σου Σιών, εις γενεών και γενεών.
Σέβος ο Σαν ο God, who rose from the dead, σέβος ο Σεν to you, Alleluia. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and to the ages of ages, Amen. Ο μόνο γεννησίος και λόγος του Θεού, αθάνατος υπάρχων, και κατά δεξάμενος δια την ημετέραν σωτηρία, σαρκώθη είναι εκ της Αγίας Θεοτόκου, γέρα η Παρθένου Μαρίας, αρτρέπτος εν ανθρωπίσας, σαρκωθείς και Χριστέ ο Θεός, θάνατον πατήσας, ίσον της Αγίας Κυριάκος, συνδοξαζόμενος το Πατρί και το Άγιο Πνεύματι, σώσον ημάς.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For you are a good and loving God, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Τον συνάδελφον λόγον Πατρί και Πνεύματι, τον ευπαρθένου τεχθένα η σωτηρία ημών, αγνημίσομεν πίστη και προσκυνήσομεν.
Father, bless the Holy
Eucharist.
Wisdom arise.
Come, let us worship and bow down to Christ. Save us, O Son of God, who salvation, let us the faithful give praise and worship. Of his own will he mounted the cross in the flesh, he suffered death and raised the dead by his glorious resurrection.
Προς αιώνιους μονάς, Κύριν και μετά θάνατον αδιαλόβητον. σώμα σου Άγιε, σιγάρεν σοφροσύνη και σεμνή πολιτεία, μακάρε πολιτεύσω μη μολύνας την σάρκα, διό εν παρησία Χριστόν πρέσβευε σωθήνε ημάς.
Together, please, the hymn of our church is on page 2 of your bulletin.
Ευλογητός η Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών, ο Πανσόφος τους αλλήλεις αναδείξας, κατά πνεύσας αυτής το πνεύμα, transfigured on the mountain, O Christ our God, and your disciples beheld your glory as far as they could bear. Thus when they see you crucified, they may understand your voluntary passion and proclaim to the world that you are truly the brightness of the Father.
Let us pray to the Lord.
For you are holy, our God, and to you we give glory, to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Holy God, you dwell among your saints, you are praised by the seraphim with the thrice holy hymn, and glorified by all the cherubim, and worshipped by all the heavenly powers. You have brought all things out of nothing into being. You have created man and woman in your image and likeness, and adorned them with all the gifts of your grace. You give wisdom and understanding to the supplicant, and do not overlook the sinner. Have established repentance as a way of salvation. You have enabled us, your lowly and worthy servants, to stand at this hour before the glory of your holy altar, to offer you worship and praise. Master, accept the praise of the blessing of the lips of the sins of his ancestors, of our voluntary and involuntary transgressions. Sanctify our souls and bodies in grace and worship, and serve our holiness all the days of our lives. By the intercession of the Lord, the Father, and all the saints, who pleased you throughout the ages.
Blessed
is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed are you on the throne of the glory of your God. us now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us.
Let us be attentive.
You, O Lord, shall keep us and preserve us. Save me, O Lord, for the godly man has failed.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Romans.
Let us be attentive.
Brethren, having gifts that differ according to the grace given to us, let us use them. If prophecy, in proportion to our faith. If in service, in our serving. He who teaches, in his teaching. He who exhorts, in his exhortation. He who contributes in liberality, he who gives aid with zeal, he who does acts of mercy with cheerfulness. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with brotherly affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Never flag in zeal. Be aglow with the Spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in your hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints, practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them.
Peace be to you, the reader. Wisdom arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the holy gospel according to Saint Matthew. Let us be attentive. At that time, getting into a boat, Jesus crossed over and came to his own city. And behold, they brought to him a paralytic lying on his bed. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Take heart, my son, your sins are forgiven." And behold, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." But Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, "Why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven, or to say rise and walk? But you that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He then said to the paralytic, "Rise, take up your bed and go home." And he rose and went home. And when the crowd saw it, they were afraid, and they glorified God, who had given such authority to men.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Good morning. Please be seated. This morning we welcome back, as is announced in the bulletin, Father Constantine Zozos, who will offer the homily this morning. Father Constantine, welcome.
Good morning. Thank you, Father. It must be summertime. It's always great to be back, which I consider my home as well, because I spent an awful lot of time with all of you in 2008. Some of you may remember me, and I understand there are so many new families here at Holy Trinity. And nice to see you today, Jim. I heard you had vacation. Today's gospel reading is taken from Matthew, but if you look at Luke and Mark, he has a different translation or interpretation of the same gospel reading. They talk about this, about Christ going to his home base, and they call that base Capernaum or Capernaum, and it was on the west side of the Sea of Galilee. He felt very comfortable in that city. Not all of us feel very comfortable in the city that we grow up in. He didn't grow up in Capernaum, but he felt very comfortable there, and the people loved him, and they waited for his arrival. And as he arrived in Capernaum, there was a paralytic that was brought to him. We know the story quite well. In fact, it's probably read at least twice throughout the year. The one time is about the paralytic who had four friends who brought him to Christ, but they couldn't get into the house, or they opened the top of the roof and they lowered him. In Matthew's translation or interpretation, they don't talk about the roof at all. But they did talk about these individuals who brought this paralytic to Christ. Now, I want you to envision something. It's not just a story. Imagine now four people holding a man with dead weight who can't walk, can't move, through the dusty roads of Capernaum. And it doesn't say how many miles they carried him in that dusty road. Miles, perhaps. Imagine the weight of that man. Just try to imagine that. And how hot it must have been, and how difficult it must have been. And yet they had something in common. They went in the same direction. They had the same cause. They had deep abiding faith that something was going to help their friend, the paralytic. And they brought him to Christ. Now, sometimes Christ says, you know, he heals the man right away, whatever the situation, the blindness, whether he's lame, whatever. In this situation, he doesn't do that at all. What does he do? He says, take courage, he says to the paralytic. Take courage. Christ must have seen something in this man that none of us would ever imagine. He understood this man and his heart. And he understood what? The faith of his friends. Sometimes it takes the faith of others to bring someone to Christ to be healed. Whether it's a disability, or whether it's a physical sickness, or whether it's a mental sickness. It takes sometimes others to do that. And here were four individuals who were his friends, who had like-mindedness, and they had deep abiding faith that this man could heal their friend. Now, we also have to understand one other thing, and this is a very controversial and difficult thing to understand. He says to him, take courage, your sins are forgiven. You see, in those days, the Orthodox Jewish people believed that a person who was infirmed, who was sick, who had a disability, who was homeless, was a sinful man. And one has to think, is that true? Does all sickness come from sin? Whether it's your sin, your parents' sin, your grandparents' sin, or just sin in general. That's a question. But we know one thing, that Jesus died for our salvation and put himself upon that cross for our sins. Yesterday, I asked a physician in your parish who I was visiting with, how do you give courage to someone who's ill? And he said to me, especially if you have something that's very difficult like cancer. And he says to me, you know, you have to instill a positive mind in this person. And it only has to start from within, but you have to help that person get this positive mind. To think good, that good thoughts will come to their mind so that they can be made well. And I do believe that if we sin and we don't take care of our sin, many of us become despondent, we have depression, and many of us get sick. So many of us hold things inside. Sometimes we share them with people who think you think are going to be like-minded about things. That we have an issue with a sibling, an issue with a parent, an issue with someone in your church, an issue with your priest, an issue with the leadership of your parish, an issue with someone in your committee of, I don't know, let's say, the festival, the choir. We all have issues, don't we? And you know, the thing is, we fester them inside, and where does our faith go? Our faith goes to the side because we seem to hone in on those things, and they bother us. And we don't know how to let go of those things. And I'm just like you. And I have a hard time sometimes as well. And if there's someone here who says they don't, then, and I'm sure these beautiful people here don't. Where is our faith? If we want to be made well, like the physician told me the other day, or do we want to continue to stay paralyzed within ourselves with the things that seem to bother and fester our lives and annoy us, then we're not going to be very healthy human beings. Can you imagine living your entire life and not talking to a child, your husband, your mother, your father? How difficult that must be. For what? Life, as I've always said, is so short. Take every moment and try to enjoy it to the fullest that you can, asking God to heal you of your paralysis, whatever that may be. And so he says to this man, take courage. And I say to you, take courage. Your sins are forgiven. Well, the scribes and the Pharisees, they were the smart people. They were the ones who knew the law so well. They had a hard time with watching a man say that to another human being, that your sins are forgiven. And he saw the reaction of these scribes and the Pharisees and the Sadducees. And this is what Jesus said to them about their thoughts. Why do you think evil in your hearts? Think about that. Why do you think evil in your hearts? And then he says to them, he played the prosecutor. We have a couple lawyers here today, I'm sure. And he says to them, what's easier to do? To say to that man, your sins are forgiven, or to say, take up your bed and walk? Who would like to answer that for me? Harry. I put you on the spot. Huh? It's a what?
You put me on the spot. I'm not ready.
You're not ready. It's a very tough question to answer. Is it easier to say to someone, your sins are forgiven, or to say to him, pick up your bed and walk, who's paralyzed? You can't see what Christ did to that man. You can't visualize that he actually forgave him. But he wanted to prove something through this event. He wanted to prove to mankind that he is the Son of Man, that he has the authority, that he has the power to forgive. And he wants all of us to know that as well. So, it's probably more difficult to say, pick up your bed and walk. Because they couldn't do it. Only he could do it. The man said, your sins are forgiven. And so what does he do to show that he has that power and that authority? He tells him to get his bed, put it on his back, and walk home. That's what he does. So he played the game with the Sadducees, and that irritated them to the very end. They were always trying to find a way to trick him. But Christ, being as smart as he was, knew what to ask them. So where do we find ourselves today? We find ourselves today in this gospel reading to make some changes in our lives. That we have paralysis, whether it's a physical one, whether something is internal or mental, and we need to make some changes. And the only way we can make some changes in God's time is to believe that he can heal us, that he can cure us, that it can make us whole again, that we can become an example to each other. We need each other. On Holy Wednesday of Holy Week, or any time the Holy Unction service is celebrated, by right it should be celebrated by 7 clergy. And who comes to that Episcopalian service? Many people. Who comes to church? Many people. This is the congregation. This is the believers. We need each other. This is the body of Christ. We are connected to each other, and we should learn to pray for each other and to love each other and to learn how to forgive each other. So today, maybe it was a start for you to say to someone, please forgive me. Even if it's your fault, who cares? The only one who cares, if you have a good heart, is the Almighty. He knows your heart. He knew the heart of that paralytic, and he knew the faith of his friends, and he knows you. That's the only one who counts. Because we live here in a very small time. We want to live in bliss, in paradise, in heaven with him forever. But this is where we need to cultivate our lives. This is where we have to make a difference in our lives with each other. And if you see someone astray, pray for him. Think about him. If someone has wronged you, forgive him, at least in your heart. And that will make all the difference in the world and will make you feel healthy and happy in your lives. Amen.
Wisdom and grant that always guarded by your power, we may give glory to you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Even for the heavenly powers, but because of your ineffable and immeasurable love for us, you became man without alteration or change. You've served as a high priest and Lord of all, and trusted us the celebration of this liturgical sacrifice without the shedding of blood. You alone, Lord our God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth. You are seated in the throne of the cherubim, and the Lord is here from the King of Israel. You alone are holy and dwell among your saints. You alone are God. Cleanse my soul and heart from evil consciousness, and enable me by the power of your Holy Spirit, the best of the grace of peace that I may stand before your holy table, and so bring your body and your precious blood. I come with bowed head and pray, do not turn your face away from me, nor reject me from among your children. Make me a sinful and worthy servant, worthy to offer these gifts to you, Christ, the God, the offer, one who receives, distributed, and you give glory to heaven, and the Father, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Will you mystically represent the cherubim, sing the thrice holy hymn to the life-giving Trinity? Let us lay aside all the cares of this life, that we may receive the King of all, invisibly escorted by angelic hosts. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Will you mystically represent the cherubim, sing the thrice holy hymn to the life-giving Trinity? Let us set aside all the cares of this life, that we may receive the King of all, invisibly escorted by angelic hosts. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Come, let us worship God, our King, deaf to proscenium and to trespasses. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Having beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. We venerate your cross, Christ, and we praise and glorify your holy resurrection. You are our God, we know none other than you. We call upon your holy name. Come, O you faithful, let us venerate the resurrection of Christ, for your hope of the cross, joy has come to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us praise his resurrection, for enduring the cross for us, he has destroyed death's side. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, according to your mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and put me in place of your knowledge, my transgressions, and my sins are before you. Against you, only have I sinned, and done that which is evil in your sight. Turn your face away from all sins of all the way. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and do a right spirit with me, and not cast away from the presence. And do not take the Holy Spirit from me, restoring me to the glory of his vision. Lord, you shall cleanse me. our God, remember your priesthood in this kingdom, always, now, and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. May the Lord our God remember those who love us and those who hate us. In peace, lift up your hands to the holy places and bless the Lord always, now, and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Βασιλεία του πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Πεβόη πετώτς, σεβόμενε άσκε Δόμνου Δουμνεζεύου εν τρου παρετσία σα, το δάχνα κουμ σι πουρουρεάσιν βέτσι βέτσι λόγ.
May the Lord our God remember us all in his kingdom, now and ever, and unto the angels of angels.
May the Lord our God remember us in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Let us complete our prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help for the precious gifts here presented. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for this holy house and those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For deliverance from affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For all that is good and beneficial to our souls, and for the peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For the completion of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For a Christian end to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
Grant.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and the Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Lord
God Almighty, you alone are holy. You accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon you with their whole heart. Receive also the prayer of us sinners and let it reach your holy altar. Enable us to bring before you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our sins and transgressions of the people. Make us worthy to find grace in your presence, that our sacrifice may be pleasing to you, that your good and gracious spirit may abide with us, with the gifts here presented and with all your people. Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good, and life-giving spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess. I love you, Lord, my strength, Lord, is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer.
Θύρας σας θύρας εν σοφία πρόσχομεν.
Πιστεύω εις έναν Θεόν, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα, ποιητή ουρανού και γης, ορατών δε πάντων και αοράτων, και εις έναν Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον μονογενή, τον εκ του Πατρός γεννηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων. Ως εκ φωτός Θεών αληθινών, εκ Θεού αληθινού γεννηθέντα, ου ποιηθέντα, ομοούσιον το Πατρί, Θεού τα πάντα εγένετον, τον δήμας τους ανθρώπους και δια την ημετέραν σωτηρίαν, κατελθόντα εκ των ουρανών και σαρκωθέντα εκ Πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας της Παρθένου και εν ανθρωπίσαντα, σταυρωθέντα και υπέρ ημών επί Ποντίου Πιλάτου και παθώντα και ταφέντα, και αναστάντα την τρίτη ημέρα κατά τας γραφάς, και ανέρθοντα εις τους ουρανούς, και καθεζόμενον εκ δεξιών του Πατρός, και πάλι ερχόμενον μεταδόξης, κρίνεζόντας και νεκρούς, ου της βασιλείας, ου και στε τέλος. Και εις το Πνεύμα το Άγιον, το Κύριον, το Ζώπιον, το εκ του Πατρός εκπορευόμενον, το Συμπατρί και Υιό συμπροσκυνούμενον και συνδοξαζόμενον, το λαλήσαν διά των προφητών, εις μίαν Αγίαν Καθολικήν και Αποστολικήν Εκκλησίαν, ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών, προσδοκώ Ανάστασιν νεκρών και ζωήν του μέλλοντος αιώνος. Αμήν.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand well, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive, that we may present the holy offering in peace.
Mercy and peace, our sacrifice of praise.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with thee all.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord.
Proper and right, to sing to you, bless you, praise you, thank you, and worship you in all places of your dominion. For you are God, ineffable beyond comprehension, invisible beyond understanding, existing forever and always the same. You and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, you brought us into being out of nothing, and when we fell, you raised us up again. You did not cease doing everything until you led us to heaven and granted us your kingdom to come. For all these things we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, for all things we know and do not know, for blessings seen and unseen that have been bestowed upon us. We also thank you for this liturgy, which you are pleased to accept from our hands. Even though you're surrounded by thousands of archangels and tens of thousands of angels, by the cherubim, seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring with their wings, singing the victory hymn, proclaiming, crying out, and saying,
Adios, 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 adios,
together with these blessed powers, merciful Master, we also proclaim and say, you are holy, most holy, you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. You are holy, most holy, and sublime is your glory. You so loved your world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. He came and fulfilled the divine plan for us. On the night he was delivered up, or rather gave himself up for the life of the world. He took bread in his holy, pure, and blameless hands, gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Likewise, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, drink of it, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Remembering, therefore, this command of the Savior and all that came to pass for our sake, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at the right hand of the Father, and the second glorious coming. Please bow your heads through the end of the hymn. We offer to you these gifts from your own gifts, in all and for all. Thus I conson si prospero men catapanda, once again, we offer you this spiritual worship without the shedding of blood. We ask, pray, and entreat you, send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. God, be merciful to me, a sinner, and save me. O Theos, lastimi, tomatolokele, soma. God, be merciful to me, a sinner, and save me. And make this bread the precious body of your Christ. And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of your Christ. Changing them by your Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. So they may be chosen to partake of them for vigilance of sins. Confidence before you and not in judgment or condemnation. And we offer you this spiritual worship for those who have crossed the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and very, very righteous spirit.
Especially for our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary.
For Saint Dionysius, the righteous mother of the Lord, Joseph,
Joseph,
Above all, remember, Lord, our Archbishop and Father Salvas. Grant that he may serve your holy churches in peace. Keep him safe, honorable, and healthy for many years, rightly teaching the word of your truth.
Remember also, Lord, those which has caused to mind, and all your people.
And all your people.
And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and majestic name, of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
The mercy of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Having remembered all the saints, let us again in peace pray to the Lord.
For the precious gifts here offered and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our loving God, who has received them at his holy, heavenly, and spiritual altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may return, send upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. We entrust you, loving Master, our whole life and hope. We ask, pray, and entreat, make us worthy to partake of your heavenly and awesome mysteries, from this holy and spiritual table, with a clear conscience for the remission of sins, the forgiveness of transgressions, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, confidence before you and not in judgment or condemnation. Make us worthy, Master, with confidence and without fear of condemnation, dare call you the heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Paterimon,
quen isuranis, aestitut nomasu, eotetu basilia su, initit telemasu, os renon keptis, tenatimon tempusion, dos min simeron, keaps min ta flimetaimon, os kimis afimet celestimon, kimis in engis masperismon, alissimas apotiponiru.
Otiso estini vasilia, ke dinamis, ke doxa, του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, νυν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Ειρήνη πάση.
Τα σκεφαλάσιμον το Κυρίο κλείνομεν.
We give thanks to you, invisible King. By your infinite power you have created all things, and by your great mercy you have brought everything from nothing into being. Master, look down from heaven upon those who have bowed their heads before you. They have not bowed before flesh and blood, but before you, the awesome God. Therefore, Master, guide the course of our life for our benefit according to the need of each of us. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, and heal the sick, physician of our souls and bodies. By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Lord Jesus Christ, our God, hear us from your holy dwelling place in the glorious throne of your kingdom. You are enthroned on high with the Father, and also invisibly present among us. Come and sanctify us, and let your pure body and precious blood be given to us by your mighty hand, and thrust all your people. God, be merciful to me, a sinner, and save me, and thrust us to me tonight. Τα Αγία της Αγίης, the holy gifts for the holy people of God. The Lamb of God is broken and distributed, broken but not divided. He is forever eaten, yet never consumed, but he sanctifies those who take of him.
Jesus.
believe and confess, Lord, that you are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is truly your pure body, and that this is truly your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to you, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy without condemnation to partake of your pure mysteries for the forgiveness of sins and for life eternal. Amen. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? If I dare to enter into the bridal chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not a wedding garment. And being bound up, I shall be cast out by your angels. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my condemnation because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not reveal your mystery to your adversaries, nor will I give you a kiss as the Judas. But as a thief I confess to you, Lord, remember me in your kingdom. Behold, I approach Christ, our immortal King and God.
praise and glorify your holy resurrection. You are our God. We know and love you. We call upon your holy name. Come, O you faithful. Let us venerate the holy resurrection of Christ. We hold to the cross. Joy has come to all the world. Ever blessed in the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. For enduring the cross for us, he has destroyed death by death. With the fear of God, with faith and with love, draw near.
Thank you.
God save your people and bless your inheritance.
In momento posto alifinon, elabomen deplae puradion, eromen pistilum.
Wash away, O Lord, by your holy blood, sins of those commemorated with the intercession of the Holy Ghost, Theotokos. Exalted, O God, above the heavens, and may your glory be above all the earth. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and may your glory be above all the earth. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and may your glory be above all the earth. Blessed is our God. Always, now, and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Let us be attentive, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, mortal, heavenly, life-giving, in awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for the perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thank you, loving Master, benefactor of our souls, that on this day you have made us worthy once again of your heavenly and immortal mysteries. Direct our ways in your right path. Establish us firmly in your fear. Guard our lives and make our endeavors safe through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary and of all the saints. For you are our sanctification, and to you we give glory, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Let us depart in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, bless those who praise you and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church and sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power. And do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to the armed forces everywhere, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights, and to you we give glory, thanksgiving and worship to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
May the blessing of the Lord in his mercy come upon you through his divine grace and love, always, now, and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to Christ our God, and hope glory to you. May Christ our true God, who rose from the dead, have mercy on us and save us as a good, loving, and merciful God. Through the prayers of his most holy and pure mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the holy glorious prophet and foreigner John the Baptist, the holy glorious apostles, the holy God-bearing fathers, the holy victorious martyrs, of the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of Saint Dionysios the righteous of Atopedi, Evdokimos the righteous of Cappadocia, and Joseph the righteous of Arimathea, whose memory we celebrate this day, our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have celebrated, and of all the saints, through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
May the Holy Trinity bless and protect you. Thank you for being here this morning.